Hi, I'm Rick Emerson, and welcome back to Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. To my immediate right is Miss Katherine Schwarzenegger. How are you today?
I'm good. How are you?
I am fantastic. We have been talking about your book, Rock What You've Got, and self-esteem issues, especially as they relate to young women. You, in the last segment, were talking about your mother, and your parents took great pains to explain to you what was real about the media, but maybe what was not so real about the media, and what was necessarily what was not necessarily healthy to follow in terms of media depiction. What other sorts of relationship advice do you have for mothers as they relate to daughters regarding self-esteem issues?
Well, throughout the entire book, I talk about the importance of a mother-daughter relationship and how, you know, vital that is for young girls going through high school and going through all these different pressures. So I have a lot of tips in there for mothers that's, you know, boxed off for moms only on how to deal with your child and how to make sure that you guys have a strong relationship. So I really, you know, talk heavily about that in the book. And, you know, I was really lucky and I had an amazing relationship with my mom all through high school, and I still do today. I talk to her 6 times a day. So I think that, you know, I was able to go and talk to my mom about absolutely anything. She had no judgment, and her door was always open for me to ask about anything, advice, boyfriends, about, you know, parties, friends, everything. So I was really lucky, and I think that that's really important so moms and daughters can have an open relationship and talk about, you know, food, to be able to talk about your body, be able to talk about pressures that you're dealing with. So I really talk about how important that is.
The context, familial context for you is a little strange. Your father first came to prominence when he was, I think, 20 years old, and he was Mr. Universe, you know, and it's a, you know, it's a bodybuilding competition.
Yeah.
How do you, coming from that sort of a background in his life, you know, growing up in an environment, again, like Los Angeles, how do you sort of square all of that in your head? What has your dad told you about the things that he did physically in his quest for appearance perfection growing up? How does that all work together?
I mean, I think people would think that because my dad was known for his figure that I would have issues with that and have a hard time dealing with that, but I really never looked and still have not looked at my dad's pictures of him being very muscular and say that I want to look like that. So I, you know, I didn't feel extra pressure because of that. I think that I grew up with fitness being a huge component of my life, and we were a very active family. We do a lot of family activities together. We do family bike rides, family tennis. We go on walks together. So I think that we're a very active group of people. We don't just kind of sit around and do nothing. So I think that's the only difference with my family compared to another family, and, you know, my dad's past compared to different guys' past.
It really is hard to imagine your family being sedentary, just sort of sitting on the couch and just kind of getting larger while you watch television. That's a thing where I'm the Abe Vigoda. I do that for everyone.
Exactly.
I can't imagine. Here's a little peek behind the curtain for everybody. So as we begin to tape every episode of the show, we usually do something we call a test question, which is where we're wired up and the microphones are on, and I will ask whoever the guest is today, who's you, I'll ask you a test question that has no bearing and no relationship to the topic at hand, just so we can get a test for audio levels. And sometimes I'll ask Adam's Family versus Munsters, Cyndi Lauper versus Madonna. Today I said Katherine Schwarzenegger, pancakes or waffles? And you said, well, waffles, I guess, but really we didn't eat either. And I'm trying to imagine what the cupboard looks like in the Schwarzenegger home, and I really can't imagine. I just nothing but lentils is what I imagine. So you have to tell me what the approach to food and diet was growing up in the Schwarzenegger house.
I mean, I think that I had the exact same, you know, upbringing as a normal kid would. So I think that, you know, I ate both good and bad food when I was younger. But I talk a lot in the book about food policing and how bad that is, because I know that, especially coming from a really big family, that there's a lot of food policing and, you know, comments like, are you sure you want to eat that? So I talk a lot about that in the book and how that is really a bad thing to do, and kind of commenting on your daughter's food and what she's eating is not necessarily the greatest thing. And, you know, that all comes with having a really open and great relationship with your mother and being able to openly discuss health and nutrition with your mother, and you can, you know, do that in a nice way where you don't feel like you're being attacked.
Is that true? I'm glad you said that, actually, because I think this is a thing where men especially just have no idea what they're doing, because I would assume, wrongly as it turns out, that that's exactly the thing you should do, that when your daughter reaches for an extra scone,
no,
you just sort of
do not do that.
Raise an eyebrow and you don't want to eat that.
No.
Put it down.
No.
What is, was there that kind of dynamic in your house? In other words, did your parents have different attitudes toward, did they interact with you in different ways in terms of helping to, you know, instill ideas of fitness or diet or whatever? And was your mom basically the one who had figured out the correct approach to that?
I mean, I think that my parents did, you know, what every parent does is go through that with trial and error. So I think that they did make mistakes just like every other parent. But I think that when it comes to making a comment and food policing your daughter, for example, that has an awful effect on her, so don't do it. But I think that, you know, you feel like you're being attacked if somebody makes a comment on what you're eating. And, you know, I think that's also, it hurts a girl's self-esteem and it makes them not confident. So I think that, you know, with just discussing nutrition and things that are good and bad to eat openly on a normal basis, I think that's much better than, you know, sitting at a table one night and picking her out and attacking her for eating something that's you wouldn't necessarily approve of.
Not that that ever happened, I'm sure. That's a theoretical example only. To my immediate right is Katherine Schwarzenegger. We're talking about her new book, Rock What You've Got. Back with more after this right here on Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV.